In my line of work, I develop for various different operating systems, such as Windows, Darwin, Debian, and sometimes even the Raspberry Pi OS. While Docker has done a pretty good job of letting us develop on different operating systems, it does struggle when the machine architectures change. For example, you can't really spin up a container for AMD 64 on an ARM 64 machine. Hello, my name's Swanee Bryson. Today we're going to look at various ways to build and run Docker containers for non-native architectures. First, we're going to start with the general requirements for getting set up. Next, we're going to use an emulator to run a non-native container on our machine. And then finally, we're going to build our own non-native container and run that. If you're using a Mac or a Windows machine, install Docker Desktop. On Linux, you have two choices. One of them is Docker Desktop, but is only supported on AMD 64 machines. The second option is to install Docker Engine by following this link here. Now I'm going to be demonstrating this using macOS, but the steps are the same regardless of operating system. Okay, so first what we're going to do is run a container which is a different architecture to the machine that we're running on. So if I go with uname-a here, you can see that this machine is ARM64. So I'm going to now call docker run, set the platform to Linux/AMD64, and then go rm AMD64/Alpine, and then I'm going to call uname on that container. Now the AMD64 Alpine container is always AMD64. And we get this error message, exec user process calls exec format error, because my machine's architecture can't run a binary for AMD64. So the next thing that we need to do is install an emulator so that Docker can actually emulate the AMD64 machine. So I'm going to go with docker run, go privileged, rm, and then there's this container which basically installs emulators for you. And now I'm going to go with install, and I could just go with AMD64, but instead I'll say all, so it just installs everything. And now if we run that command again on the AMD64 machine, we no longer get an error and it tells us what type of machine it is. Now we're going to build our own non-native container. So I'm just going to jump in here and make a Docker file, and we're going to make this really trivial. So it's just going to be two lines, from alpine/3.17.1. The command is just going to be that same uname command. And we want to build it, but we don't want to build it for ARM64, we want to build it for AMD64. I'm going to go docker build x, and then build /platform/linux/AMD64, and then I want to tag it with uname AMD64, and then we're going to build the container in the same folder, and then go /output type=docker. So it's a pretty long command. Just to break it down a little bit, build x is what allows us to basically build what they call multi-platform. So it allows us to build multiple architectures. Build x requires that we provide an output type. So that's why we include that at the end. So we'll just enter this, and it's going to build our container. And now we have a container called uname AMD64. And because we have the emulators installed, we can just run this with docker run /platform/linux/AMD64, where you can give it the name of the container, which is uname AMD64. Docker's multi-platform features let us run and build non-native containers on our machines. I've been Swanee Bryson, happy building, and I'll see you later.